three pans of cinnamon rolls, and none of them got eaten.
I ate two.
Good.
I know, I don't.
I didn't get all of these off.
Yes. Where's your necklace?
I just want to put these so that I feel comfortable and not.
Do you want to put them in my?
Do you have something that zips?
No. Well,
the wedding was a 7 o'clock in the evening thing, thank God. So they had plenty of time to get him to the emergency room, get wrapped up.
So handsome! You're so handsome!
He's like, man, I'm out of here.
Is everybody okay up here? Do y'all need anything?
Into some yoga moves right now. Just cool. Nothing where I gotta spread my legs.
Okay.
Echo watched Frozen and she goes, Mom, if I have a coronation, does that make me a queen? I was like, no, sure. Honey, you're a queen already. You don't have to have a coronation.
I have a son that makes me.
Oh, well, you'll have to go from there. Wave hi to the camera. So we're ready. Look, your daddy sent you a message.
I think right now.
Let me see. There's something in the back of my. I've decided when I get married, I'm just barefoot.
We may need some help on this, but she doesn't get her.
Alright, just you're not gonna start at the bottom. Okay. Otherwise, you squeeze all the fat up.
Right.
It does. You start at the bottom.
That's like the Margaret show.
Is that
feel right? It feels right. It feels right to me.
Tuck this under.
Problem.
Do you want to hold like right in the middle first to get past the?
That's right.
Empty ring box.
Alright, now you're looking
at them.
What do they look like?
Yeah.
One's just a silver band. I didn't see Carrie's though. I don't know what hers looks like.
What are those for?
Jesse's is just a silver band.
I've got two
minor. I don't have any of these.
Me either.
Are you okay?
I know, it's hard to see over all this. Is this a good placement?
Sorry,
ladies? Good placement?
Oh, yeah.
Well,
I have
pockets. It has
pockets.
Isn't that
amazing?
I know, and that's awesome.
That's gorgeous.
I completely love
pockets. I've got tissues.
My running
hand.
30
minutes?
Yeah, I just want a couple.
I don't either because I thought they're surely they're just cheap.
Yes, I'm going to leave my clothes in my phone.
Yeah, so I'm going to put mine right by your
phone. Okay, perfect.
Yeah, they're...
What's this?
Hi! Here.
Look, who's that, Chris?
Dee!
Look, Chris.
Dee!
Is someone over there that's going to pin it on me?
She's probably about 7 years.
You remember that correctly. Somebody takes it away from you, bring it back.
House William? Isn't that his name?
Yeah. She's a girl of few words. Clear for surgery.
Are you going to write any advisory?
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I have a John to
get. Oh, I have a John. Don't go to bed mad. Just stay there. You're always right.
That is true. Advice to the newlyweds.
Just stay out of
faces at each other or something. Good. Love it. Okay. Got it. Okay. Let me do one more of just you standing here, and then I'm going to have to go on.
Fresno to learn the trade, but didn't take the plunge.
Yeah. It's
so I went up.
Yeah, I love it up there.
Think about Virginia. Now, there's a small wine industry in Virginia. The wineries aren't like in Napa where they're just... Mm-hmm. Stacked, you know, you can just go right
yeah,
turn.
Yeah, bam, bam,
right
bam.
Turn. It's a little bit more. Hey, we're gonna take a drive.
This is all. Jesse, remember Will?
It's been a long time.
Long time.
Wow. Congratulations,
thank
brother.
You.
I'm glad you guys made it.
Looking good. Are you excited?
Yeah. Very.
20 years in the making.
Thank you.
together before God to witness and bless the joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. God established the bond and covenant of marriage at creation. Our Lord Jesus Christ tells us that let not man separate what God has joined, and the Holy Spirit enables us to preserve that bond when we walk with Him. Marriage signifies to us the mystery of the very union between Christ and His bride, the church, and it is to be honored by all. Marriage is not to be entered into lightly and without thought, but to be entered deliberately and in accord with the reasons that God made it. It's been my privilege to get to know Jess and Gary over the last few months. We spent a lot of time together. And I can tell you today, as they come to join this holy union, that they don't take it lightly. And I have confidence in them that this is something that they aspire to do with Jesus at the center of it. Who gives Gary to be married to Jess?
We do.
Father, we come before you today to celebrate the love between this man and this woman. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, and it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails.
This is bad.
You've got to let it go. These words are from the Apostle Paul, and they echo through churches and wedding chapels around the world, that the love of God is what extends to us as we celebrate today. Brides and grooms eager to join together in marriage, optimistic about this beautiful thing called love. Love that never harms, it never holds grudges, it never remembers callous words spoken in rage. You're going to get to practice that a lot. We talked about that in premarital counseling because we are just people. But it is a beautiful dream and a beautiful picture of what could be. Imagine it with me 5 or 10 years down the road as life gets busy and hard, and they'll remember this day and the promises they have made to each other. Love never fails. I take you, Carrie. I take you, Jess. When nerves are frayed, they remember love is patient and love is kind. And they join their lives and their families together. They will remember love never fails. It always hopes. It always perseveres. I take you, Carrie. I take you, Jess. They are challenged to follow God's highest calling and to show each other love, even when they don't feel like it. Love is not rude. It is not self-seeking. I take you, Carrie. I take you, Jess. Because love never fails, a beautiful dream for us to remember. The continuation of 1 Corinthians, the rest of that passage that we all know, the love chapter, it talks about that love never fails. And it's a picture of what's going to happen when we're in heaven one day, face to face with God. We'll understand what maybe we don't understand on earth. We all have a lot of questions. But we will see... we'll see it face to face when we're with Jesus one day. Now, the passage goes on to say, now, so all other things are going to fail, but love will not. Even among faith and hope, only love will last. You might think, why? Because it is the greatest. Not because faith and hope aren't important. Because they will end, like prophecies and knowledge. When we are at last with God, when we see face to face, we will no longer need faith and hope. We'll have God. And we will sit still and have love because it is His nature. He is love. So let's put Him in the story today, because sometimes we don't feel the love, but we know that God has it for us. So let's put Jesus in that passage. Jesus is patient. Jesus is kind. Jesus is not rude. Jesus keeps no records. And Jesus always perseveres. And Jesus says, I take you, Carrie, and I take you, Jess. In sickness and in health, for better or for worse, rich or poor, it's a picture of your union together. Just as Jesus loves us, you have that power because you have Jesus to love each other, even when situations are not always easy. Because He never fails, and He will never fail you. He never does.
Jess, do you take Carrie to be your wife, and do you commit yourself to her to be responsible in the marriage relationship, to give yourself to her in love and work, to invite her fully into your being so that she can know who you are, to cherish her above all others, and to respect her individually by encouraging her to be herself and to grow in all that God intends? If so, say I do.
I do.
Carrie, do you take Jess to be your husband, and do you commit yourself to him to be responsible in the marriage relationship, to give yourself to him in love and work, and to invite him fully into your being so that he can know who you are, to cherish him above all others, and to respect his individuality by encouraging him to be himself and to grow in all that God intends? If so, say I do.
I do.
Jess and Carrie, as it is your desire to join this covenant of marriage, you will now repeat the vows after me. Jess. Jess and Carrie are making a covenant to each other before God and you, these witnesses, with the promise of their vows. I take you, Carrie.
I take you, Carrie.
As a gift from God.
As a gift from God.
To be my lifelong companion.
To be my lifelong companion.
Through tears and laughter.
Through tears and laughter.
Sickness and health.
Sickness and in health.
Work and play.
Work and play.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Constantly and prayerfully.
Constantly and prayerfully.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
Open and honest with you.
Open and honest with you.
I will respect, trust.
I will respect, trust.
Help and care for you.
Help and care for you.
I will share my life with you.
I will share my life with you.
I will forgive you as we have been forgiven.
And I will forgive you as we have been forgiven.
I will lead you with a simple, just, and peaceful heart.
I will lead you with a simple, just, and peaceful heart.
I will love you and be thankful for the blessing of your love.
I will love you and be thankful for the blessing of your love.
Until death parts us.
Until death parts us.
Carrie, your turn.
Okay.
Jess.
Jess.
This is a pledge of my undying love to you.
This is a pledge of my undying love to you.
Forever, I promise to love you.
Forever, I promise to love you.
Forever, I promise to cherish you.
Forever, I promise to cherish you.
And forever, I promise to honor you.
Forever, I promise to honor you.
I take you to be my husband.
I take you to be my husband.
Under the hands of God.
Under the hands of God.
And may we live in peace and harmony.
And may we live in peace and harmony.
Everything we have been through together has brought us closer and closer.
Everything we've been through has brought us closer and closer.
And as the time goes on.
And as the time goes on.
We will continue to love each other.
We will continue to love.
And on this day, we are finally becoming one.
And on this day, we are finally becoming one.
I will forever continue to be by your side.
I will forever continue to be by your side.
With faith, hope, and love.
With faith, hope, and love.
It's time for the rings. So get your rings.
We totally messed this up. Yeah, that's terrible. How did we do that?
You're good. As a token of this covenant, you will now give and receive the marriage rings, the unbroken circle, the emblem of eternity, and the precious metal, which is least tarnished and most enduring, are to show how lasting is the pledge that you have made to each other. Just repeat after me as you place the ring on Carrie's finger. With this ring, I wed you.
With this ring, I wed you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Carrie, repeat after me as you place the ring on Jesse's finger. With this ring, I wed you.
With this ring, I wed you.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
As a part of the family nature of marriage, we recognize William and Annabelle and the significant role they are playing in this union that we are celebrating today.
so you can go and present them to them while I'm talking. Jess and Carrie are presenting a family medallion to William and Annabelle to remind them of their family's ties to each other. These medallions are a symbol of family commitment and in recognition of the hope and joy made visible through this marriage. Marriage is often symbolized by two merged circles. The family medallion has three circles. To acknowledge love as a relationship of more than two people. When two people love each other, they reach out and include others. Ecclesiastes 4:12 talks about the power of three cords. Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves, and the cord of three strands is not quickly broken. So Jess and Carrie, repeat after me in unison. In giving of these family medallions,
in giving of these family medallions,
we pledge to you, William and Annabelle.
We pledge to you, William and Annabelle.
Our continuing love.
Our continuing love.
Even as we surround you now.
Even as we surround you now.
With arms of support and protection.
With arms of support and protection.
With us. Creator God, you made us in your own image, male and female, that together we may live as members of your family. And as you surround us with never-ending love, strengthen us that we too might reflect your love. Becoming ever supportive of and loving one another in times of sorrow and in your presence, we are humbled by the recognition that today we face a new future, one which love has unfolded and is unfolding evermore before our eyes. May we respect the sanctity of this gift. And as you have filled us with joy, may we share the strength, our deepening love for one another, and with our family and friends. Amen.
Amen.
Jess and Carrie have made their marriage vows today with each other before God and before all of us here. Therefore, I pronounce them to be husband and wife. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Jess, you may kiss your bride. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I introduce Mr. and Ms. Jess Rowland and William and Annabelle.
Thank you.
She's coming. We're gonna go sit down.
Number 9 here. So, Lori, what do you have to say to the happy couple that just got hitched?
Congratulations to you both. Be silly, work hard, love each other, forgive each other, and that's it. Lots of laughter and joy and all that other good squishy stuff.
All right, what about you, Stephanie?
I'll say ditto to all of that. Have fun, enjoy each other, always forgive, and remember to prefer each other.
And I would say hold grudges. Wait, that kind of goes against. That's a different video. Yeah, absolutely. Make sure and always only argue about what you're actually arguing about, and don't take things personally, and just enjoy all the moments that you have. And we love you all.
Yep.
That's it for table number 9.
Hi guys, thanks for letting me be part of your day. I have fun being the music person and the person to point. Glad I'm healthy enough to be here. Love you guys.
Hey, Carrie and Jess, I just want to say that I'm so happy for the both of you and that you're finally pursuing all the desires of your heart.
We love you.
All right. Hey, congratulations, guys. Long time in the making. And I guess the number one thing is it's about time. So congratulations. It was beautiful. And hope y'all make some wonderful memories in the future.
Congratulations, Carrie and Jess. We love both of you, and we hope you have many, many, many happy years together.
Hi, Carrie and Jesse. We are all so excited about your new marriage and life together, and we're just glad we were here to share it with you. And we hope you have a blast and your honeymoon, and we will see you when you get home. Love y'all. Bye.
Jesse and Carrie, I'm very proud of you guys. I
wish you nothing but the best. I hope that God blesses your union tremendously, that he run your cup over. Annabelle, William, I love you guys to the moon and back. Miss Toya is here for you whenever needed. Love you guys. Great luck. Smooches.
Stand straight at me. It feels weird, but yeah, just like that. And you're gonna hold your knees up. There you go. Good. Let me see what I can get again. Carrie, can I get you to squeeze your feet? Are they announcing you? I can go tell them. There you go. Great. Okay, let's bring over here. Let's get
you break?
No.
That's good. Yeah. Good, and stay there. I'm going to get some beef.
Summer before my junior year in high school, I was out cruising with a couple of girlfriends from work and we swung by one of our usual stops, Putt-Putt in Plano, Texas. We went in looking for cute guys, and that is where I first met the boy that would steal my heart. My friends introduced this girl from Allen, Texas to their classmate from Plano in the middle of the game room, and I immediately had a crush. We decided to all leave together and we headed to the parking lot where my new-to-me car was parked. I was pretty proud of my sweet black Honda Prelude, and Jesse apparently liked it too and jumped in it and he stole it. So the rest of the night I went around chasing him in my stolen car. We started dating a few months after that and became an item for a whole 6 months, and in high school, that's a long time. We would call it off to spread our wings and fly and keep coming back to find each other over the course of 4 years. We experienced a lot of firsts together. I cheered Jesse on the first time he rolled a bull. He cheered me on in my volleyball games. I was with Jesse the first time I got in trouble with the cops. They let him go. They're not in jail, they're here. We're all good. He took me on dates, family functions, and loved me, even though I was unrecognizably swollen for months when I had my wisdom teeth removed. What a sweetie. He was the first guy I took to Muskogee, Oklahoma to meet my grandparents. He taught me about and installed my first CB radio. His handle was Bootlegger, and I was Pixie. Isn't that cute? Aww, can we get an aww? He was my first love and my first heartbreak. After high school, I went out to the military and then to college. We got together when I was home on leave, and I would try to see him when I was in town from school. But eventually, our paths got further and further apart, and he moved to Colorado and got started on his life, and I stayed in DFW, and I got started on mine. Fast forward 15 years, and he was Facebook stalking me. That's how it went. He popped up one day and said, "Hey, I see you're single." The rest is absolutely here history. They messaged back and forth, and they took a chance on love again, and here we are today. Aww. Aww. If they're ready, and I'm not sure they are. I would like to announce Mr. and Mrs. Jesse Rowland.
Others who broke my heart, they were like no one. Jess and Carrie, it's been a privilege to be a part of this special day. May God bless your marriage for a lifetime.
And as they say in Pathways, it's only hard.
Jesse and Carrie. Carrie was at my house the night before y'all went on your first date, and she texted you all night long. She was so very excited. We were trying to do a project, and really, she just paid attention to her phone. So it's an honor to be here today, and God bless your relationship forever.
Hi, Casey and Jesse. I'm Stormy Boudreaux, and I don't know either one of you, but I couldn't turn down free booze.
And that's the one I married. So, hi, Jesse and Carrie. I just wanted to remind you to celebrate every single day. That's my message. Love you both.
Hi, Carrie and Jesse. I love you guys. And I just want to thank you for letting me be part of your special day and your princess day, Carrie. And thank you for inviting us into your lives like this. And I wish you an incredibly happy and long-lasting and passionate marriage. Okay, thanks.
Thank you.
Just give me a cheer, laugh, whatever. Okay? It has been said in private, this person sings at the top of their lungs, windows down, hair blowing through to Jesus Take the Wheel. It has been said that this person can make the meanest pizza in the world. Their first job was at Little Caesars. Pizza, pizza. It has been said that this person first broke their parents' heart when they snuck out of the house with eggs and toilet paper. Then they got caught and had to work off the damage for the rest of the summer. Is super self-conscious about their butt. By the way, does it look big to you?
It looks perfect.
It has been said that this person made personal use of a JCPenney waste basket for the restroom. Because when you gotta go, you gotta go. It has been said, when this person tries to impress someone, they hide their inner child that secretly loves boogers and stealing toilet paper.
I know.
It has been said, in high school, this person had to lay down to button their jeans.
I was
fortunate enough to attend
graduation
meeting, group meeting type thing, and I was extremely impressed with the participation and the commitment that those individuals are showing to each other. And in that light, I hope that, and I'm sure that Carrie and Jesse will have that commitment to each other throughout their marriage. Number two group that I'd like to recognize is Carrie's immediate family. Brother and sister and mother, I don't think that I've ever seen a closer-knit family, and as you all know, that's what made this country great, was the family. And I'd like to thank each and every one of you for accepting my youngest son into your hearts.
Aww. Aww. Thank you.
I hope that, and I know that he'll continue to stay there. I see, do see a commitment there, and you do have a great family.
Thank you.
You're up.
Wow, that's hard to follow. It's just so wonderful to watch people grow and to see love reunited. How often does that happen? You know, that you have this wonderful chance to have a second chance. I wish you guys all the love and happiness and joy. Very traditional, that you both can hold within your hearts from now and forever. I love you guys.
We're good.
Yeah, that's what it is.
goodness. Yum. Cool. All right.
Somebody's got to do it, right? We have two lines.
Yeah.
You're a bad girl.
You may go at some. Please, Carrie and Jesse would like to have a family dance with their children, stepchildren. And let me go turn it on so they can shake their groove thing.
Thank you.
ask for a better day, to be surrounded by all our friends, our families. And just thank you so much for being here with us today, celebrating our new beginnings. All right.